It's a 1980s television set. Recently restored it. It had been in pieces for many years. I had restored all the electronic parts and put the TV back together, so I essentially built a television set. Nothing was together. It was all in pieces. Had to be constructed. The result? And this is after capacitor and resistor replacement. Over 60 had to be replaced.
And my magic finger. Not the one I use in traffic, but my magic finger.
And it turns on quick, too. I had the TV on about like 30 minutes ago, and it's turning on pretty quick.
Can we roll the first?
This pitch, this color, is phenomenal.
Here we have a parasailer. We have gravity involved, so you have a sense as you watch the show what's going to happen next. Kabam! Now, let's take that in slow-mo.
Now, those little patterns you're seeing, that's just
now,
the camera.
See him going into the perfect
that's because the camera's resolution's clashing with the resolution of the TV's shadow mask. It's a Moyer pattern. I believe that's how you pronounce it. Moyer. It's annoying, effect, but it's not present. The picture is phenomenal. Colors are looking great. I just gotta say, I've never seen a TV look so nice. Let's see here. Family Guy. Lots of commercial right now. But I found it interesting. What it most interesting is how different the colors are than a modern television. It's just kind of funny. No. It's just so different. Yellows especially. Reds are quite different, but yellows are massively different. I'm trying to find something that might look good on this. Let's see here. What would look good? Animated cartoons look good on it.
Extremely. Hope. In case you're wondering, I'll be getting that orchid before you. Because I've got a secret weapon. Awesomeness. Not a chance. I'm faster than you at everything. Except eating.
And you see, even with all these reds, it can still do subtle green colors. You know, it's just, it's NTSC, yet it looks good for NTSC. I like it. And you know, what's funny is you can always fine-tune adjust with these knobs. A lot of people always play with these things. But you know, there's a little knob inside. What does it do? Let's you fine adjust.
Pick up the pace. Me? You couldn't pick up the pace with a shovel. Oh yeah? Watch me flap.
I like adjusting it right here. This is my favorite sweet spot for tuning the tuner, though. It's a good, good setting. Nice and clear picture. Not too sharp where it's showing all the interference lines. And just, you know, sometimes you just don't want to make a picture too sharp. Sometimes it needs to be a little softened. And this is proof right here. This is a phenomenal looking picture. Anyway, that's a 1980s Hitachi. Let me see what the model number is. Let me just change my white balance back to normal on my camera, because I had it white balanced to actually match the TV's picture tube, because it is very different in color. Let's see here. Model number. Model number CT1302. And as you saw, it had the 1980s manufacture date.